नियतिकृत नियमरहितां ह्लादेकमयीम् अनन्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिम् आददति भारती कवेर्जयति. वि आर् लुकिङ्ग् एट् द सेक्षन् दोषाणाम् अदोषत्वं. विल् हाव् टु लुक् एट् द नेक्स्ट् वन् विच् इस् निर्हेतोः अदुष्टता. ख्याते अर्थे निर्हेतोः अदुष्टता. सो निर्हेतु आर् वेर् देर् इस् अ हेतु इस् एक्स्पेक्टेड् अण्ड् दट् हेतु हेस् नाट् बीन् प्रोवैडेड् दट् इस् अ दोषस्थलम्. So where it is not a dosha, if the hetu is something which is very popularly known, then we don't need to provide it in the shlokam, and it is understood by the reader very naturally, then it is not a dosham, it is in fact a gunam. Chandram gata padmagunan nabhunte padmashrita chandramasim abhikyam umamukham tu pratipadya lola dvisham shrayam pritim avapa lakshmi. This is in Kumarasambhava. Lakshmi or beauty, she first tried to go to Chandra. So she wanted to be in a place which is sadrisham for her, and she wanted to be happy in a place which is also beautiful. So generally we say that the moon is very beautiful. So at night she goes to the moon. The moment she goes there, she feels it is lacking in something. So chandram gata lakshmihi padma gunana na bhunte. She is not able to enjoy the beauty that is there in padma. Each lavanyam is something which we experience in one person. It is not the same thing in each person, right? So we experience it in different ways. So chandram gata sati Lakshmihi padma gunana na bhunte. She was not able to enjoy the qualities of a lotus. Padma shrita sati chandramasim abhikyam na bhunte. When she was with the lotus, she did not find the beauty that is associated with chandramasi, the chandra, moon. So when she went to the moon, she could not enjoy lotus, and when she went to the lotus, she could not enjoy moon. Why? What is the difference here? Idea is, let's look at the shlokam fully and then I'll come. So uma mukham tu pratipadya lola esha. Lakshmi is by nature lola. You should read Shukanasa Upadesham to understand why she is lola or fickle. She goes to one place and then finds it is lacking with something, and then she moves to another thing. So she keeps moving like this, and then she looks at Uma Mukham, Parvati Mukham, and Parvati Mukham tu prapya pratipadya. After she went there, dvisam shrayam pritim avapa. The happiness she got from being in both places, Chandra as well as Padma, both she could attain here. So she had double happiness in Uma's face because it was more beautiful than the Chandra and the Padma. So the idea of giving both the Chandra and the lotus is Atra Ratrau Padmasya Sankochaha Diva Chandramasaha Nishprabhatvam. In the morning she was looking for something which is very beautiful and she could go reside. The lotus had bloomed, so she went there. At night, the lotus closes, and so she went to the moon and tried out. Because in the morning, the Chandra does not have a prabha. That is the reason here. So, Chandramasim na bhunte, kimartham padmagunana na bhunte, chandram gata sati, katham padmagunana na bhunte, iti hetoho apeksha vartate. So if there is an expectancy for a reason, what can be the reason? We know very well that in the morning the lotus blooms, hence she could be there, and the Chandra does not have so much of beauty that the Padma, the lotus has. At night, it is only the moon that has the beauty, whereas the lotus does not have the beauty. There was no place where she could enjoy both beautiful objects. Then when she got to Parvati's face, that is where she saw both beauty. Present, both of those beautiful aspects present. So atra ratrau padmasya sankochaha diva chandramasaha cha nishprabhatvam loka prasiddham iti na bhunte iti hetum na apekshate. So na bhunte iti, that you know, that vakyam does not expect a hetu, बिकास् द सङ्कोचः पद्मस्य सङ्कोचः एण्ड् चन्द्रमसः निष्प्रभत्वं लोकप्रसिद्धम्. सो निर्हेतु इस् यु केनाट् पायिण्ट् औट् द दोष निर्हेतु. नेक्स्ट् वन् इस् अनुकरणे तु सर्वेषां, दिस् इस् द कारिका पोर्शन्. That A is given in bracket because if you see, sorry, if you see the earlier karika, khyatarthe nirhetu radushtata anukarane, it should come along with that, and that's why the A is given in bracket in the karika. So anukarane tu sarvesham, anukaranam means shabdasya tadrupena abhidanam, or you are just following whatever someone has said without saying anything. Many times we find in our house a child will just repeat whatever the elders have said, whether it understands the context or meaning or where it should be used, how it should be used, the child doesn't care. That's why we have to be very careful when we speak in front of a child. So anukarane, when you are just following what someone else is saying, nobody is going to find out a dosham in that. So sarvesham shruti katu prabhritinam doshanam anukarane adoshatvam yatha mriga chakshusha madraksham ityadi katayatyayam pashyesha cha gaviti aha sutramanam yaja iti cha. There are a couple of doshas that he has pointed out in the shlokam. So it is like a reported speech. Someone is saying, you know, that person is saying mriga chakshusha madraksham iti saha vadati iti ayam katayati pashya eshaha go iti aha sutramanam yaja iti cha aha. That's your sentence. So someone is pointing out and saying, see, he's such a not such a learned person that he is using words like this. Or mriga chakshusham adraksham. Mriga chakshusham is mriga netri, mriga nayanam adraksham. It is the context is Shringara, and she is an alambana vibhavam here. You have to use when you're using it in the case of Shringaram, you should not use Shruti Katu or Samyuktakshara Bahulyam Navara Nabhavitabhyam. So Adraksham, that word especially, is Shruti Katu, but he is only Anukaranam, imitating someone else's words, then it is not a dosha. Go iti sa pashya eshaha go iti aha. Go is not a word at all. See, go is just the pratipadikam. You cannot use a pratipadikam in a sentence. So I am gauhu. You can't say I am go or iyam gauhu, iyam go. Go is as such does not have any kriya nivartakam is not there for a pratipadikam. Only when it takes on su or au, jas and all those sup pratyayas, then it becomes useful for a kriya. So pratipadika matra prayoge chyuta samskritihi doshaha, but since he is pointing out someone else's words, it is not a dosha. Similarly, sutramanam yaja, indram yaja. Instead of indra, he uses the word sutrama. Koshe patitamapi, it is not widely used, or it is not at all used in classical literature. It is only found in Vedic literature. Hence, it is an aprayukta dosham. But since someone else, again, anukarane sati, atra na dosha. Okay. Next is vatradi. Yes. Good.
Adi, the Adhika Prasingi Tharman, Kelly, the Sutrama Mitra Mande. சம்புல வருதுல்ல இன்னும் இவருக்கு அந்த போஜராஜரோட இடிச்சுட்டே இருக்கேன் சுத்ராமா வாஸ் அது படிக்கிறச்சு அதனால
அது பிராசத்துக்கு யூஸ் பண்றார்
ஓகே
one or two na eko hi dosho guna sannipate nimajjatindo kirnesh vivanka avladha but dosha ha tu dosha ha eva adu namma
I think it's there in amarakosha. I remember one shloka.
It is there in amarakosha. Koshe patitam That is, there is no doubt about it. But just because it is written, so Daivatam and Kwachit Pumsi, that is also there. But Daivataha is not something that should be used. The entire dosha section handles that, right?
Hmm.
Even though Koshe Patitam Api, Kavye, that is why Shastra Kavyadhyaya Vekshanath is very important. You have to have studied the Mahakavyams that people have written and what is the usage that they have handled. Only in accordance to that you can write.
Hmm.
This is just to point out. And if at a later stage, after a few centuries, Sutrama may become a popular usage. Now today, nobody complains about Aham Gatavan or Aham Gatavati. When you just stop the sentence with that, you cannot, right? Aham Gatavati Asam Asmi Bhavishyami. It has to be followed with that.
Yeah.
Today, it has become accepted.
Hmm.
What to do? So maybe at some point Sutrama will be accepted in Kavya. We don't know.
Ellarum Jambu Ramayanam kandipa padikkara illaya ipo. Sanskritam padikkavaala.
And later someone might come up with explanations and say that it is okay. There are several usages and those Kavyams have been praised as great Kavyams. So we have to rewrite Alankara Shastra Dosha Prakaranam and someone might write it. So... Next one is Vatradi Auchitya Vashate Dosha Api Gunaha Kwachite Kwachite Na Ubhav. So there are two sections here. Vatradi Auchitya Vashate Vatra Bodhavya Kaku, all these things, right? So Vatra Bodhavya Prakarana, there is a set of list that you can take there. He only deals with some of them. And Tesham Auchitya Vashate, if the Vakta is a Vayakarana, then he can use great words, or if someone he is trying to tell a Vayakarana, then he can use show off his Shabda usages and all that. So, Vaktradi Auchitya Vashat, by the propriety of Vakta, etc., Doshaha Api Gunaha Bhavet, Kwachit, Kwachit Staleshu, Doshaha Gunaha Bhavet, Kwachit. Na ubhav. Even if Vaktradi Auchityam is also there, some places na ubhav ityukte gunaha api nasti, dosho api nasti. I cannot say that it is dosham. At the same time, there is no chamatkaram in it, there is no rasatvam in it, and hence there is no, I can't say that there is a gunam also. So that is also acceptable, possible. Vaktra pratipadya vyangya vachya prakaranadinam mahimna. So these are the five things that he points out in this. He takes examples of five of these. So vaktra auchityadi or vaktra mahimna, pratipadya mahimna, pratipadya bodhavya, one who is the shrota, one who, or bodhavya, yaha, saha. Vyangya is rasam, depends on the rasam that is. So when I said, even in, when we were talking about dosham initially, Shruti Katu and all that is not a dosham in case of Raudradi rasa. There Shruti Katu is a gunam. So he will take up another sthalam where it is a bibatsa rasa pratipadakam. So vyangyam, next is vachya. Vachyam is what is the meaning that is conveyed. Prakaranam is the context. Yesham mahimna doshaha api kwachit gunaha kwachit na doshaha na gunaha. Tatra, first is vakta. Vayakaranadau vaktari pratipadye cha raudradau cha rase vyangye kashtatvam gunaha. So three examples we have to take here. One is vayakaranaha yada vakta athava pratipadyaha. Bodhaniyaha janaha. That is the second example. The third example is Raudradi Rasabhyankya. In these three, Kashtatvam is not considered as a dosha. In fact, Kashtatvam is a guna. Kramena udaharanam yatha. Didhin vevin samah kaschit guna vridhyoho abhajanam kvip pratyaya nibhak kaschit yatra sannihite nate. Didhing is a dhatu, waving is a dhatu. சோ கஷ்டித் வையாக்கரணா ஹி கோஸ் டு அஸ்மின் கிராமே கீதிருஷாக லோகாக இது பிரஷ்னஸ்ய உத்தரம் இதம் கஷ்டித் புருஷா வததி சோ கஷ்டித் வையாக்கரணாக வததி அஸ்மின் கிராமே யுவர் ஆஸ்கிங் அ வையாக்கரண கிராமேரியன் அஸ்மின் கிராமே கீதிருஷாக லோகாக சந்தி ஹவ் ஆர் த ஜனாக சந்தி தென் ஹி ஆன்சர்ஸ் சோ கஷ்டித் புருஷா தீதிங் வேவிங் சமஹா He is like the Deeding Dhatu and the Waving Dhatu. Deeding is Deepti Devanayoho. Waving is actually, the meaning is to conceive or to project. There are different types of meanings for that. So, but these two Dhatu, the speciality of these two Dhatus are, it does not take either Guna or Vriddhi. So, guna letters are at yengcha guna samnya syat, vriddhihi is at aichcha guna vriddhi samnya syat. Now, these usually, I think the sutram is didhi vevitam, right? Didhi vevitam iti sutrena guna vriddhi nishedat. In Panini sutram, mostly in certain cases, you will have a guna or a vriddhi being applied to the dhatu. But for these two dhatu, guna and vriddhi are not applied. Based on the sutram, didhi vevitam. Guna is not applied. Neither is vriddhi. The letters do not get its guna letter, nor is it replaced by its vriddhi letter. So, guna vriddhyoho abhajanam. Now, what he actually means is, guna can mean two things. One is, vyakarana ritya adeng gunaha, loka ritya tu shaurya dhairyadi, गुणाः ही डज नॉट तस् गुणानां भाजनं नास्ति कश्चित् पुरुषः देयर इज नो पर्सन हियर हु हैज ग्रेट क्वालिटीज नॉर इज देयर अ पर्सन हु हैज अटेंड प्रॉस्पेरिटी सो समृद्धिः वृद्धि आल्सो मींस प्रॉस्पेरिटी व्याकरणे आदैच लोकेतु समृद्धिः ऐश्वर्यं दैट इज प्रॉस्पेरिटी मेन्मै அப்படி சொல்றோம்ல சோ देयर इज नो पर्सन who has good qualities, nor is there a person who is prosperous. Next, kaschit kvipratyaya nibhaha yatra sannihite na te. So, in case you didn't understand the first line, he is giving another example saying kvipratyaya nibhaha, kvip iti pratyaya. In kvipratyayam, all of those letters are lopa. So you add quip to some pratipadikam or something to make an for a grammatical operation. I think ik, iv, e, and pa. These are the four letters that are there. So ik, iv is lashakotadhite iti lopaha. E, ava, I think where apratasya iti lopaha. E vandu upadeshe ajanunasika iti. Pa vandu halantyam. So all of those letters disappear. None of those remain. Okay. So, quip pratyaya nibhaha. He is a person who is like a quip where he completely disappears. If he is present, if that person is present, that is, there is no quality that we can attach to him. His presence is not at all felt. That is quip pratyaya nibhaha. Yatra sannihite, if he is nearby, that also you don't have guna and vriddhi na te ityukte guna vriddhyoho nishedaha. So even in Panini sutram, if there is a kut pratyaya and kut pratyayasya lopaha uktaha chete tatra king iti cha iti sutrena guna vriddhi vriddhyoho nishedaha. So loke, a person who disappears or who has nothing to say, we have nothing to say about him. There is no good quality in him. His presence is not at all felt. Even such a person lives here. Hence, how do you expect guna and vriddhi in this village? So, vakta vayyakaranaha. Next is vayyakarane bodhaniya jane sati. So, yadatvam aham adraksham padavidya visharadam padhyayam tada asmarsham samaspraksham cha sammadam. So we know that a person who hears is a vayyakarana. பதவித்யா விசாரதம் துவாம் அகம் யதா அத்ராட்சம். வென் ஐ சா யூ ஹூ இஸ் அன் எக்ஸ்பர்ட் இன் பதவித்யா வியாக்கரணம் இன் கிராமர், ததா அகம் உபாத்யாயம் அஸ்மார்ஷம். ஐ ரிமெம்பர்ட் மை டீச்சர் உபாத்யாயா. சோ உபாத்யாயம் அஸ்மார்ஷம் சமஸ்பிராக்ஷம் அஸ்பிருஷத். சோ மாம் சம்மதம் சமஸ்பிராக்ஷம். சோ ஐ காட் டச்ட் பை ஹாப்பினஸ் சம்மதா ஓர் ஹர்ஷா. ஐ இம்மீடியட்லி காட் டச்ட் பை ஹாப்பினஸ் சம்ஸ்பிராக்ஷம் ஸ்பிருஷ தாது. சோ திஸ் லக்கிலி ஹி டசன்ட் கிவ் எனி சூத்திரம் ஃபார் அஸ் டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் தட், பட் த வேர்ட்ஸ் சம்ஸ்பிராக்ஷம் அண்ட் அஸ்மார்ஷம், தீஸ் ஆர் ஆல் வேர்ட்ஸ் விச் இஸ் ஸ்ருதி கட்டு, பட் சின்ஸ் இட் இஸ் த வையாக்கரணா ஹூ இஸ் அ லிசனர் தென் இட் இஸ் ஃபைன். ஆர் கஷ்டத்வம் இஸ் ஆல்சோ அ தோஷம் ஹியர் வேர் யூ டோன்ட் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் வாட் த மீனிங் இஸ். நெக்ஸ்ட் இஸ் பீபத்சரசம். I like this actually. Instead of there are many vibhatsarasa, not many vibhatsarasa shloka are said. So here antra prota brihat kapala nalaka krura kunat kankana praya prenkhita bhuri bhushana ravaihi aghoshayanti ambaram pita chardita rakta kardama ghana pragbhara ghorollasa ோரோல்லசத்து வியாலோல ஸ்தன பார பைரவ வபுஹு தர்போத்ததம் தாவதி. மகாவீர சரித்தே ஐ திங்க் லக்ஷ்மணா ஆஸ்க்ஸ் காபுனர் இயம் இது உபக்ரமிய லக்ஷ்மண கர்த்திருக்கம் தாடகாயாக வர்ணனம் இதம் பீபத்சரச வியஞ்சகம். சோ த ரசம் ஹியர் இஸ் ஜென்ரலி வி நோ ஃபார் ரௌத்ர ரசம் சஞ்சத் புஜ பிரமித சண்ட கார்முக Rucha, in Veni Samharam, you will find a lot of shlokas which are reflective of Raudra Rasam. So this is for Bibatsa Rasam. Kapunariyam, Kapunaha Iyam, that is your avatarika that is there in front, before. Adhik perena Chulikava, Churnikava, where you start off with a small Gadhya Bhagam which is connected to the Padhya Bhagam in a Nataka. So Kapunaresha, தர்ப உத்ததம் தாவதி. ஹூ இஸ் திஸ் லேடி ஹூ இஸ் தாவதி ரன்னிங் இன் ஃப்ரண்ட் ஆஃப் மீ தர்ப உத்ததம் ஹூ இஸ் ஃபியர்ஸ் அவுட் ஆஃப் ஆங்கர் உத்தத ஷி இஸ் வெரி ஃபியர்ஸ் அவுட் ஆஃப் அரகன்ஸ் தர்ப உத்ததம் கா ஏஷா தாவதி புரஹ. சோ த ரெஸ்ட் ஆர் ஆல் அட்ஜெக்டிவ்ஸ் ஃபார் ஹர். So, Bhushana Ravaihi Ambaram Aghoshayanti. She is Aghoshayanti. She is resounding the sky. She is making the sound, sky very noisy. Aghoshayanti Ambaram Akasham. With the Bhushana Ravaihi, with the ornaments, the sound of ornaments. So, her ornaments are all making a sound. What are these ornaments made of? Antra Prota, Antra intestines. So prota, it has been threaded with the antra. Brihat kapala, big kapalam, head, skulls. Nalaka is a femur bone, jangalam or asthi. It is like the big bones that are there in your skeletal system. That is nalaka. So kapala, nalaka, krura kwanathu. So her mala and abhushanani are only these asthi, bones and kapalam. So kwanathu, it is making a sound, kankanam, tadrisha kwanathu kankanam dharayati, dharati esha. So praya prenkhita bhure bhushana ravaihi, she has so many abhushanani which are made of kapala and nalaka. Abhoshayanti ambaram. Next is her vapuhu, her shariram is bhairava vapuhu, it is very terrible to look at, it is bhayankaraha. How? She has drunk and vomited raktam, rudhiram. So pita chardita vanta. So pita chardita rakta tasya raktasya kardama pankaha. So sheer madri irukku, adha thick blood stains are there on her bosoms, on her body. So kardama kardamena ghana pragbhara ghora ullasat. Very easy to understand. So ghana pragbhara, her front portion is very thick because of that raktam which has come out of her mouth. Ghoram, it is terrible to look at, and ullasat, it is also showing off that raktam. So raktena ullasat. Vyalola stanabhara stanabhara, her bosoms are moving, and because of that it is bhairava bapuhu. So her body is very terrible to look at. Tadrisha ka esha darpa uddhatam davati. Who is she running here? So the dirgha samasatvam and the kashtam, the difficulty in understanding the meaning of that long samasa, is actually a dosham in Shringara Karuna, especially in Karunam, Vipralambam. But in Vibhatsa, it is a guna. Okay. Next is Vachya Vashat. Vachya is what? Vachya Mahimna Kashtatvasya Gunatvam Aha. So who is being addressed here? Who is the person, that is the meaning of the person who is being addressed here? Which is a Simham. So we'll look at the shlokam and then I'll tell you. Matangaha kimu valgitaihi, kim aphalaihi adambaraihi jambukaha, sarangaha mahishaha madam vrajatha, kim shunyeshu shuranake, kopatopa samudbhatotkata sata kotehe ibharehe puraha sindudhvanini hunkrite spurati yat tad garjitam garjitam. The first half is, see, matangaha, someone is addressing the animals of the jungle and saying, see, you can all make noises and walk around in arrogance, or show off your madam. Only you can all do that only when there is nobody else to challenge you. When the lion is roaring, that is the roar. You can all make whatever sound you want, but roar, when a lion roars, let's see if you can show your prowess in front of that. Ibharehe puraha yat garjitam tadeva garjitam bhavati. Ibharehe simhasya purataha yat garjitam tadeva garjitam bhavati. He matangaha kimu valgitaihi. Valgitam ityukte gaja shabdaha. The plural in grol nolio. Tamil. English lana trumpet and solrada. The sound that is produced by matanga, elephants, is called valgitam. You cannot use that for horses or anything. So it's very specific. I think we saw that in another dosha section also. Matanga kimu valgitaihi. Why are you making a sound or crying or trumpeting? He jambukaha kim abhalaihi adambaraihi. There is no use for your adambara, for your show. What is the use of all this show? Kim abhalaihi adambaraihi. He sarangaha mahishaha madam vrajata. Why are you so proud? Kim madam vrajata? Why are you showing pride? Shunyeshu shuraha na. Keva shuraha na. So shunyeshu, shunyasthaleshu, when there is nobody in solitude, who will not be brave? Ke na shuraha bhavanti. Kopa atopa samudbhata udkata sata kotehe ibharehe puraha yat garjitam. So before that, sindudhvanini hunkrite spurati sati. When the ocean-like sindudhvanini, the garjitam of simha, the roar of a lion, is like the sound of an ocean. So when that, just hunkritam, not even garjitam, he says, shingo urumardhimba. உருமினாலே போறோம். நாட் அது வந்து அப்படியே பெருசா இது பண்ணணும்ங்கிறது இல்ல, கர்ஜனை பண்ணணும்ங்கிறது இல்ல.
நல்லா இருக்கு.
ஆமா, இந்த ஹூங்கிருதம்க்கு வந்து எனக்கு ரொம்ப பிடிக்கும் அந்த வேர்டு. சோ ஹூங்கிருதா இஸ் ஜஸ்ட் லைக் அ சாஃப்ட் ஹம்மிங் ஆஃப் அ லயன். இட்ஸ் ஐ காண்ட் ஈவன் ஃபைண்ட் அ வேர்ட் ஃபார் இட் இன் இங்கிலீஷ். ஓகே, யூ ட்ரை டு ஃபைண்ட் ஒன் இன் யுவர் லாங்குவேஜ். So Sindhu Dhwanini, which is like the Sindhu ocean sound, Spurati Sati, when that rumble, okay, when that rumble is there, you can try that. Spurati Sati, Kopa Atopa, because of anger, this lion is shaking its mane. Sata Kote, it's Sata Koti, the Koti, the Samuham, Sata Samuham, its mane, it is Udbhata, it is very Samudbhata, Kopa Atopam. Atopam means it is shaking. So the lion is shaking its mane out of anger in a very fierce manner, Samudbhata. Tadrisha Ibarehe Puraha, yad garjitam tadeva garjitam. Alilla Urukku Ilippappu Chakramba. When there is no growl. Growl is not
a... Google. அதான் சொல்றது.
Google, la?
Okay. தெரியல, ஆனாலும் வரல.
அந்த உருமருதுங்கிறது வேற. It is neither a roar nor a growl. You can say it's a growl, I guess. But growl is more like a dog, not a lion.
எனக்கு
ஊருக்கு இழுப்ப பூச்சக்கரன்னு ஆள் இல்லா ஊருனா ஆளுனா சுகர் கேன். When, when you don't find sugar cane in a country, then ilippa poongiradhu, I think ilippa ingiradhu oru type of maram. Maram verithu enna enna? Ilippa maram. Adhanudaiya poo dhaan vandhu chakkarayaar dhaan. So you take just a flower and use it as sugar instead of if you don't find sugar cane. So when an expert is not present, anybody can say they are an expert. It doesn't say who has written the shlokam. Okay. Vachya vashat. Atra simhe vachye parushaha shabdaha. Now, the point here is, when he is talking about matangaha, jambukaha, sarangaha, mahishaha, if you look at the first half of the shloka, it is entirely small, small words. There are no samasa. And there is no Parushaksharam also present there. Because you don't want the Ojo Gunam for the other animals. You want to tell that they are not as great as a Simha. So when you want to show the prowess of the Simha, and when he is talking about the Simha in the second half, there he uses all the Parushaksharam. And Dirgha Samasam, Vikata Varnaha. So, when the Simha, which is Ojo Guna Yuktaha, so you want to say that is the meaning that is that needs to be conveyed. Hence, you're using Dirgha Samasa, which is an Ojo Guna Prakashaha. Dirgha Samasam and Vikata Varnam. Hence, it becomes a, it is not a dosham, but a gunam. Okay. Next is Prakarana Vashat. Now, it's a very interesting shlokam. It is there in Vikramorushiyam. Many texts don't have this shloka, but some of the texts also have this as a Patabedam. Pururavas is in Viraham, and he is asking the Ashoka tree, where is Urvashi? So, here, Rakta Ashoka, Krishodari, Konugata, Tukta, Tyaktva, Anuraktam Janam, No Drishteti Mudhaiva Chalayasikim, Vatavadhutam Shiraha. Utkantha ghatamana shatpada ghata sanghatta dashtachada tatpada hatimantarena bhavataha pushpodgamoyam kutaha. It is a Vipralamba Shringara shloka. You should not find that third line there at all. But he will give you prakarana vashat because of context. Let's look at the context. Hey Rakta Ashoka, he is asking the rakta, the words rakta and ashoka itself are very contextually aujitya padam. Rakta means anurakta. At the same time, it also means rakta varna. Ashoka இஸ் ஷோக ந ஷோகா அசோகா. சோ வென் விரஹி ஜன கம் டு தெம், இட் இஸ் பிகாஸ் ஹி இஸ் வெரி அனுரக்தம் அண்ட் ஹி ஆல்சோ டசன்ட் ஹாவ் ஷோகா இன் ஹிம். ஹி ஷுட் ஆக்சுவலி பி கண்டியூசிவ் டு த பீப்புள் ஹூ ஆர் இன் விரஹம். So he should be like a friend. The Ashoka tree should actually behave like a friend to the Virahijana. But what is this Raktashoka doing? He's asking Raktashoka, Krishodari, you know, the girl who has a slender waist. So here he is talking about his Naika, beloved. So where is my beloved? Kwanugata sa anuraktam janam imam tyaktva. I am so much in love with her and I am attached to her. Maam tyaktva sa kutaha kva gataha kasmin deshe gataha. So gata, where has she gone? No drishta iti mudhaiva vata avadhutam shiraha chalayasitvam. Kim, why are you unnecessarily moving your head? Vata avadhutam shiraha, your head is being moved avadhutam by vata, by the wind. No drishta, I have not seen her. Iti mudhaiva, in vain you are chalayasi, you are moving your head. So he is asking, where is Urvashi? The Raktashoka is actually, there is a breeze there, and so it is moving this way and that way. So he interprets it. This is Unmada. Clear state of Manmatha Avastha, Unmadaha, where Chetana, Achetanatva, he doesn't know the difference between the Chetanatvam and Achetana Vastu. The moment the Ashoka tree is moving like this, he thinks it is replying to his question, no Drishta, I have not seen her. How can you say that you have not seen her now? Pururvas is very angry now. He is angry and he is actually saying, see, tat padahatim antarena, without her dohada. Ashoka tree is supposed to give forth, bring forth flowers when a lady hits the tree with her leg. Tat padahatim antarena, without being hit by her or without her dohadam, bhavatah pushpodgamah kutah I am. How did you bring forth flowers? So the adjective for pushpodgamah is the flowers which whose petals chada are dashta, I have been bitten by shatpada ghata sanghatta. A group of bees are trying to sanghatta, they are in a rush to come and bite the, or actually take the madhu from the flower, but because they are fighting with each other, they are actually biting off bits of the petals. So your petals have been, the flowers and the petals and the flowers have been bitten off by shatpada, which is utkanta ghatamana, ghatamana, because utkanta means that eagerly they are swarming. So out of utkanta, out of eagerness, the bees are all swarming towards your flowers. And how did such a flower come about without her performing the dohada action? Here, prakarana vashat, even though it is Vipralamba Shrinkaram, he is angry at her, at the Ashoka tree. So he is using utkantha ghatamana shatpada ghata sanghatta dashta chadas. தத்வாதாஹதிமந்தரேண பவதஹ புஷ்போத்கம குதஹ. அத்ர சிரோதூனனேன குபிதஸ்ய வசசி. சோ சிரோதூனனேன அவவாத அவதூதம் சிரஹ. யூ மூவ் யுவர் ஹெட் அண்ட் சே தட் யூ ஹவ் நாட் சீன் ஹர், தென் விச் மீன்ஸ் யூ ஆர் லைங். சோ ஹி கெட்ஸ் ஆங்கிரி. சோ குபிதஸ்ய வசசி, தட் இஸ் த பிரகரணம் ஹியர். த கான்டெக்ஸ்ட் பியூட்டிஃபுல்லி கிவ்ஸ் வே ஃபார் விகடவர்ணா. I think I've written the same here. Don't look at that. So Vikata Varnam, which is so the which is actually a gunam here and not a dosha. Next is we finish off this section with Kvachit na doshaha naapi gunaha. One minute. I think he finishes with this. Next, he goes on to another set of dosha. So we'll finish with this slokam. So kvachit nirase na gunaha na doshaha yatha. So here, शीघ्रघ्राणाङ्घ्रि पाणीन् व्रणिभिर् अपघनैः घर्घराव्यक्त घोषान् दीर्घाघ्रातानघै अनघ ओघैः पुनरपि घटयत्येक उल्लाघयन् यः घर्मांशोस्तस्य वो अन्तर्द्विगुण घन घृणा निघ्न निर्विघ्न वृत्तेः दत्तार्घाः सिद्ध संघैः विदधतु घृणयः शीघ्रम् अम्भो विघातम्। सो घर्मांशोः घृणयः वः अम्भो विघातम् शीघ्रं विदधतु। सो घर्मांशोः, घर्मांशु इस् वन् हू हेज़् हाट् रेस्, घर्म अंशु, सो विच् इस् द सूर्य। सो दिस् इस् अ श्लोकम् रिटन् बै मयूरकवि इन् इस् सूर्यशतकम्। इट् इस् अ चित्रकाव्यम्, सो दट्स् वै यु हेव् अ लाट् आफ् द लेटर्स् घ इन् इट्। देर् इस् नैदर् अ गुणं नार् केन् यु से इट् इस् अ दोषयुक्त श्लोक। घर्मांशोः घृणयः वः अम्हो विघातं शीघ्रं विदधतु। अम्हो विघातम्, अम्हसां विघातं, पापानां विघातं विदधतु, करोतु। सो लेट् सूर्यस् घृणयः किरणाः वः युष्माकम् अम्हो विघातं पापनाशं करोतु, शीघ्रमेव विदधतु। हु यः, इन् द फस्ट् हाफ् इट्स् इस् यः जनान् उल्लाघयन् पुनरपि घटयति। ओघ अघ ओघैः अघौघैः, यः एकः एव, एको भूत्वा, एकाकी एव, वन् हू इस् जस्ट् अलोन्, जस्ट् बै हिम्सेल्फ् ही रिमूव्स् द पापम् आफ् आल् द पीपल् हू आर् सफरिङ्ग् फ्रम् द डिफ्रेण्ट् व्याधि दट् इस् देर् एण्ड् ही घटयति, पुनरपि घटयति, ही गिव्स् देम् अ न्यू बाडि, घटयति, ही मेक्स् देम् लुक् लैक् एस् इफ् दिस् इट् वास् नाट् अ डिसीस् रावेज्ड् बाडि। सो शीर्ण घ्राण अङ्घ्रि पाणीन् पुनरपि घटयति। सो अघ ओघैः पापसमूहैः, बिकास् आफ् द डिफ्रेण्ट् पापम् दट् दे हेव् मेड्, शीर्ण घ्राण अङ्घ्रि पाणीन्, their limbs have all, ghrana means their nose, angri legs, pani is hand, all these three are shirna vishirna, they've become they've lost their strength with very weak nose. I think not just nose is a representative of all the bahirindriyam, angri pani is the karmendriyam, so jnanendriyam and karmendriyam have all become vishirna. It's not doing its function properly for these people because of what? Agha oghaihi, because of the papa sahasra karanat chirnaha angani, chirnani angani. So vrani bihi, because of vranam is I think rogam. Let me look at the vyakhyanam, it's easier to just read from the vyakhyanam. Vrana yukta, vrana is in the punnam, boils or any sort of wounds that are there in your body. So vrani bihi apaghanaihi angaihi, the rest of the angas are all filled with wounds. Such people, because of that gharghara avyakta ghoshana, they are constantly moaning, making sounds which are gharghara. They're making such sounds which is avyaktam, which is not clear, no sputa words are coming out of their mouth, so it is just a noise, moaning noises that they are making, such people. And then dirgha aghratana, and they are sighing constantly, taking deep breaths because they are not able to breathe properly. Such people who are vyadisthana ullaghayan, ullaghayan, he removes their rogam. Nirogi kurvan, vyadi nirmuktan kurvan, punarapi ghatayati bhuyopi navikaroti, he makes them new. Granadibihi nutana avayavaihi sambadhnati, he gives them new organs with which they are able to lead their lives. Surya, this is all yaha, suryaha, janan, roga, rogina, உள்ளாகையன்னு புனரபி நவசரீரயுக்தான்னு கரோதி. தஸ்ய கர்மாம்சோஹோ அனதர் அட்ஜெக்டிவ் ஃபார் தட் சூர்யா இஸ் அந்தர் த்விகுண கன க்ரிணா நிக்ன நிர்விக்ன விருத்தேஹே. ஸோ அந்த ஹிருதயே த்விகுண பகுலா கன நிபிடா யா க்ரிணா கிருபா தன்னிக்னா ததாயதாக நிர்விக்னாக விக்னரஹிதாக. ஸோ இஸ் விருத்தி த வேஷ் சூர்யா works is his vritti or his vyavaharam, his effort is always in such a manner that he has so much of kripa. Grina is kripa, ghana grina, he has so much of kripa towards his bhakta devotees, which is antar dviguna ghana. It is dvigunam, it he has a double kripa inside of him. I don't know why he says dvigunam here. I'll have to read the original vyakyanam for this to understand. So ghana kripa tan nigna tad ayatta nirvigram. So he has a very unrestricted compassion to his devotees. Tadrish suryasya ghrinayaha vaha papana vaduri karoto. So shlokam here, it's a shabda chitra kavyam. Even though there is a Kavinishta Surya Bhavaha Ratihi and all that is there, where he is, his bhakti is there, but still there is no essence, or there is no beauty in this, where there is a dhvani or and you appreciate it. It is only the way the poet has displayed his shabda skill. That is what we is much more prominent here in this shlokam than the Surya Bhakti, Adeva Vishayaka Rati. Okay. So here there is neither Gunam nor Dosham. Chule. Hello? Doubt Rika?
Yes, sir.
Okay. No doubt, Leah? We'll stop with this.
Yeah.
Sure.
I don't know.